Hello everyone, I'm Adrien Forgman and today I will present you our work with Geoffroy Peters, which has been financed by Future Pulse Project at IRCAM, named Extending Deep Prism for Tempo and Genre Estimation Using Complex Convolutions, Multitask Learning and Multi-Input Network. So the Deep Prism method has been published at Izmir 2019. It aims to adapt an harmonic decomposition of rhythm to a deep learning formalizer in order to perform two tasks. A task of global tempo estimation and a task of rhythm-oriented genre classification. To achieve this, we have developed a new representation, the harmonic constant Q modulation, that we use as an input of a deep convolutional neural network. In our new paper, we want to extend this method. We're going to see how in this presentation. We begin by presenting the deep rhythm method with this question: what is an harmonic decomposition of rhythm? According to Peters, computing the discrete Fourier transform of the onset strength function of the audio signal allows to represent the harmonic decomposition of rhythm as an harmonic series H. Here, the distance between successive beats is considered as a fundamental tempo value. To adapt this harmonic decomposition of rhythm to a deep learning formalism, we would like to use the harmonic series H as the depth of a convolutional neural network, using the harmonic constant Q transform presented by Bittner to perform fundamental frequency estimation allows to represent an harmonic series. Given an harmonic signal, several CQT are computed by multiplying the lowest frequency in its range by H. The result is the HCQT, a 3D representation with a depth of H, where the superimposition allows to identify the fundamental frequency over time and its harmonics thanks to the harmonic decay induced by H. Based on these two methods, we developed a new representation that we called harmonic constant Q modulation. Here, instead of applied the discrete Fourier transform to the onset strength function, we apply directly the harmonic constant Q transform to a set of onset strength functions which represent the rhythm content in several acoustic frequency bands, as in the work of Marchand with the scale transform method. On the right figure, we can see an HCQM example for a given time window, equivalent to 8 seconds. We therefore obtain a 3D representation which represents the modulation frequency, so the evolution of the frequency energy, set up to coincide with the probable global tempo. Here, the probable global tempo is about around 120 BPM. We can see it in black dotted lines. H is the harmonic series or shifted coefficient and the harmonic decomposition of rhythm in B frequency bands. This representation is then used as the input of a convolutional neural network. It is followed by convolutional layers that convolve through depths, keeping the same phi b size at each layer. Filter size are set up to encompass several frequency bands, and we choose a large filter in phi in the last layer to take into account all the relations between various modulation frequencies that are relative to rhythm component. As output, we have a dense layer with a softmax activation function to perform classification as in the work of Schreiber and its end-to-end tempo estimation. We use the same architecture to perform the two tasks independently. In the case of tempo estimation, we have 256 classes and the ground truth is the global tempo value between 30 and 285 BPM. In the case of genre classification, we have n classes corresponding to n genres of the evaluated dataset. We propose three extensions to improve deep rhythm following music knowledge intuitions. So we want to allow to represent the interrelationships between the acoustic frequency bands. We want to gently learn the model in order to perform the two tasks simultaneously. And finally, we want to exploit the benefits of other music knowledge descriptors in addition to rhythm in order to improve classification. For the first extension, we would like to allow the model to take into account the interrelationships between the different acoustic frequency bands. To do so, we propose the use of a complex representation as input of a complex convolutional neural network. So given two different rhythm patterns, we can notice that for the first one, bass drum and snare are played simultaneously, and for the second one, they are played alternately. In our HCQM representation, those two patterns are considered the same since the HCQT of each acoustic frequency band are computed individually. To differentiate those patterns and allow a better tempo estimation, it is important to take into account the interband relationships. To do so, we propose to maintain the phase information and so the temporal position information of the rhythm component by keeping the complex values of the HCQM instead of keeping only the modulus of the HCQM in the computation of the HCQT step. Then we stack the real and the imaginary part of the representation and use it as input of a convolutional neural network. To perform a complex convolution, we use the method of TravelC, described by TravelC. Given the real imaginary input representation, we convolve it with complex kernels, and the resulting filter maps have two parts, a real one and an imaginary one. The network is described like the original deep rhythm one by replacing the convolutional layers in the original deep rhythm by the complex convolutional layers. We keep the same output as the original deep rhythm with C equal either to the tempo classes from 30 to 286 BPM or either the genre classes. We evaluate this method according to the same protocol as for deep rhythm. For tempo estimation, we use a large-scale evaluation protocol using three large datasets as train sets and seven datasets and the combination of them combined as test sets. The three large datasets are composed of various rhythm-oriented genres, from ballroom dances to EDM music, and also to popular music. For genre classification, to ensure a reliable evaluation, we use a tenfold cross-validation on five different datasets independently. In the original deep rhythm method, since the HCQM is computed on different temporal slices for a given track used as input of the CNN, the average of the softmax prediction vectors over time is computed. We propose to compare the result of the Oracle frame prediction, meaning that we keep only the best softmax prediction vector over time according to the ground truth tempo value. It should be noted that this method is a manual selection and allows to represent the upper bound of our tempo estimation methods. So in terms of accuracy one, the exact accuracy within a 4% window centered on the tempo ground truth, the Oracle complex deep rhythm perform better for all the datasets except for the ballroom one. However, watching the genre classification results, we can notice that there is no improvement compared to the original method. This can be explained by the fact that adding the phase information in the learning process does not allow the model to optimally generalize. Second, we want to gently learn a model to perform the two tasks simultaneously. For this, we propose a multitask learning. We perform the two tasks independently in the original deep rhythm method. We would like to learn the two tasks simultaneously in the same model, since we assume they are highly related. In fact, some genres are defined by the rhythm patterns played at specific tempo ranges. For this, we choose a null parameter sharing strategy, meaning the two tasks have specific layer at the end, but the hidden layers are shared and shared the parameters during the model learning. We start from the original deep rhythm method network. Following the R parameter sharing strategy, we replace the output by an output dedicated to the learning of C genre classes and an output dedicated to the learning of 256 global tempo classes. We minimize the addition of the two categorical entropy losses in order to learn the model. We can therefore notice that the classic deep rhythm network performing the two tasks independently, there are twice more parameters than for this a multitask learning network architecture. The results are displayed are the one for the tempo estimation in terms of accuracy one, and the one for the genre classification in terms of average mean recall. The results of multitask learning and complex multitask learning are obtained using the same model, while for DPRISM and complex DPRISM methods, we use an independent tenfold cross-validations for both tasks. We can see that using multitask learning slightly improve tempo estimation for 3 of 4 datasets. We can also notice that for the electronic dance music dataset MTG, best results are achieved using complex multitask learning. Finally, we would like to add more information in the training than only the reason-based descriptor. For this, we propose to add another branch to the DPRISM network. So with the original DPRISM method, we perform a reason-based analysis using the HCQM reason representation as input to the DPRISM network dedicated to the reason content analysis. So we want to improve genre classification by taking into account another descriptor that defines genres, the timbre. To do this, the solution we propose is to add another branch dedicated to timbre with a male spectrogram as input of a VGG-like convnate described by Choi in his work to perform large-scale automatic tagging. For this, we start again from the DPRISM network. And next to it, we have the male spectrogram as input to a convolutional neural network. This network is based on the VGGNet architecture with convolution max pooling operation between each layers. Finally, we concatenate the two outputs, flattened vectors, followed by a dense and a softmax layer. Here again, we have C as the genre or the tempo classes. We also evaluate an architecture, multi-input, multitask, with the two outputs, each one dedicated to one of the two tasks. We first present the results for tempo estimation in terms of accuracy one. As for the precedent evaluation, the multitask methods are applied to the learning of both tasks, and for the others, we use a tenfold cross-validation protocol. We can observe that for the multi-input method, it performs better for the Ballroom and the Jizan datasets, while for the multi-input multitask learning, it performs better for the extended Ballroom dataset. Genre classification results are more significant since the multi-input method and its complex version perform better for all datasets. So to conclude, finally, we showed that the use of complex representation and complex convolution allow to represent the interrelationships between the acoustics frequency bands B and improve tempo estimation. The use of multitask learning allows to gently learn the model in order to perform the two tasks simultaneously and improve tempo estimation and genre classification, but only on specific datasets. And finally, the use of multi-input network allows to exploit the benefits of timbre descriptor in addition to reason in order to improve genre classification for all the evaluated datasets. Thanks for your attention.